Hey guys, it's Snowstorm, and I am playing Smite and listening to Drake Bell. I'm 18 years old, what the fuck is wrong with me? This used to be one of my favorite shows in the world. But, anyway. Sorry, I need to stop playing. I'm actually here for a jungle tutorial on Box Four. This is my first of probably a series of I'm going to play a conquest match. I'm going to choose gods that I have to play with, and I'm going to jungle with them, or mid, or solo, or duo, if, you know, Shadow ever happens to actually be here. But, you know, we'll do some joint digs, we'll have some fun, but let's start off with what you need to jungle Bakasura properly. First of all, you need the Death Machine skin. You can be the best jungle Bakasura ever, but you have absolutely no skill if you do not have the Death Machine skin. Beaster Bunny is a close second. Beaster Bunny is a second. Anyway, we're probably going to lose this match because, you know, four players versus five. I don't see this going out. Oh, hey, he's finally showed up. Anyway. Let's just, let's enjoy a game, you know? Well, first off, I'm going to run down what you need to start off with in buying. What I normally start off with, personally, is one rank of hand, a potion of physical might, and boom boom mass. This is how a lot of people tend to start with jungle, as far as I'm aware, that's what I had heard. I started using it, and quite honestly, I do quite well. But this build is actually something I have been working on for 2 months now since I started, and it serves me well. What ability you want to start off with is the ability to eat people, because you can heal. And because of Boomba's mask, oh god, it's Nickel Bass. Because of Boomba's mask, I forgot to pop my potion. Wow, that feels smart. Because of Boomba's mask, you get healing like 10% of their maximum health, plus you get the healing from But seeing as I didn't need it, it wasn't much of a problem. Now what we're going to do is we're going to be... A credit card that's got no limit and a big black chain with a bedroom in it. Gonna join the Mile High Club at 37,000 feet. Wait, no, I don't have to knock it. I want a new tour bus full of old guitars. Mine star out in Hollywood Boulevard. Somewhere between Cher and James Dean is fine
anyway.
For me.
So
And that's our first kill of the game. That's actually kind of impressive, considering I didn't think I was going to get a kill, but... Your second ability you want to get to is your Butchering Blade, because he doesn't like play on Stall Blade.
Why you go off on?
I wanna be great like Elvis without the tassels. I ain't body got the love to be
a vassal.
Sign a couple lot of grass.
I am not dead yet, and I refuse to die. And right about now, I'm kind of happy expecting a standard person, even though there's one of the match just spooked out. Anyway, so let's go over Baka's ability. His jump is your basic escape, immediate initiate, you can get out. I prefer to use to get out, but you'll see a few times, maybe the place where we're all using to initiate, because I feel like a boss. His eating people are already semi-covered. His Butchering Blade, when installed, to do more damage. And his passive. His passive is actually kind of interesting. The more enemies you kill, you get a boost to your attack speed and your movement speed. And that's, if that's not helpful, then I don't know what helpful is. But, you know, the ability to move faster and attack faster, you can deal more damage. The only downside is you have to keep it up, and that's a problem, because you'll find very quickly that Baka is not very effective. I mean, yeah, everyone has the same base game increase, but Baka, for some reason, maybe it's just me, I'm pretty sure it's just me, actually. He tends to not move as fast as you would see in a first game. Considering, you know, I'm like this nobody who's telling you that Bakasaur is slow, you should trust me because I'm a voice on the internet. But he tends to run a little bit slower, and I mean, it's not a big problem. It's annoying, it really is, but Arachne tried to use a dip on me and just not trying to get him back. And hopefully we can get unfortunately, we did actually fuck people up. Did we? Yeah, we did. Wow. I mean, I knew I was going to kill him. That's just the way this game works. But no, I actually didn't think I would kill him. I thought the Merc had got me. Apparently not. But your basic initiate is, as I strongly urged against, yet decided to do anyway. I jumped in to initiate. I popped my ult, and then I popped my three. Now, I don't know if that actually works. But back before one of the most recent updates, you could pop your 3 while you were ulting, and it would do more damage. And I don't know if that's still the case. I haven't actually paid enough attention to tell you if that was still the case. But I do know that I do it anyway, just because I think it lasts longer than the ult. And if not, it still looks cool. It's a flaming mouth. You know, what do you want? Anyway. Getting back to this, that's your basic strategy for ganking, is always have your ult ready. If your ult's not ready, you'll probably go and die. I mean, that's just the way it works. If your ult's not ready, you are probably going to die. It didn't have to be fun. I really wouldn't. Use that to get rid of the minions. I did not pop my ult because I don't think it's going to do anything. I mean, it might do a little damage, but if I don't kill him, what's the point of popping him? Get around it. I am, however, going to kill minions because I'm starting to attack some of the jungle items. Heartseeker. Oh, God, where do I start with Heartseeker? Every minion you kill, you get one stat. You get a max of 50 stat, which means you get a max of 50 physical power. Now, don't take that out of context. That does not mean that you're going to get... That does not mean that every item has stacks with going to give you power. Sometimes it's okay, sometimes it isn't. But for this one in particular, you get stacks. Every stack counts as basically one physical power. You get 2 stacks for a god kill, and then back to minions. And this Merc is going to die. He died. We did our job. The Agni is alive. And that is how you jump along. I didn't really bother to stop because I didn't see the point, so it's possible that I could have a good way to avoid that, everyone's probably aware of it, but if you stop moving right before countdown ends, you're not going to get stuck. But some people might not know that, in which case, you can get a moment. That's bad. If I had more mana, I think about that. So we go back and we get one of the next crucial parts of this build. Fatalist. Oh, God, Fatalist. Where do we start with you? Fatalist is the answer to everyone's issue who says, I cannot keep up with them when I get this. Every time you hit someone, that speed debuff is removed for a second. That doesn't sound like much, but believe me, it is. Because that's 1 second that you're moving and you are not hampered by anything. Wait,
Are they going to die? I don't know if he is. Fine. He did. 7 kills, 1 death. I think we're doing pretty damn good. Could be wrong. I'm getting the feeling we're going to be surrendering up here in a sec. I might not. I might. Now it's dead. Anyway, going back to what I was talking about, we just killed 3 people. And being told to calm down. Anyway, you might not, if they surrender, you might not even get to see the full build, but actually, the sad truth is, that's how a lot of these games go. If you play Baccarat, or you get a string of lucky kills, he becomes fed, and once you have a fed Baccarat, there's really next to no way to getting him to stop, because he's just going to keep on feeding and feeding and feeding, and that's going to hamper a lot of your leveling abilities. I hate to say it, that's a big problem. I mean, I play Baccarat because I fucking love Baccarat's story. Thanks to Shadow. But, I'm going back to this now. It still presents a problem. Because if you play Baccarat right, you stomp everyone. Murky really has to be stomping. Why did I have cone damage? I'm not gonna argue. But yeah, stopping the... Oh god. Ow. In my defense, she's evil. So I'm not going to deal with that. At the moment. I will, however. Now there's no tower. Guess who's going to get fucked up? Not her, because she's hiding. That's a mercy. Thanks, Merc. God, I am stomping. Can we afford to be stupid? No, but we can't afford to be stupid. And like I figured, they're going to surrender. I'm sorry, guys. I'll try to get up another video explaining this. But yeah, I'm being praised. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks.